Hello and welcome to another episode of Five Things, an independent web series dedicated to answering the five burning tech questions you have about technologies and workflows in the media creation space, tech stuff I dig, and how it's used. I'm your host, Michael Kammes, and today we're looking at dialogue search from Nexidia, indexing and searching for content based on audio. Let's get geek started. When not being used by the government to monitor your phone calls, office conversations, or noises in the bathroom, the underlying technology in Nexidia's dialogue search can be used to index the audio within your sound and video files and create a searchable database of those media files. This gives you, dear viewer, the ability to search on the details of your content, not just subject keywords, but the actual content, verbatim, within the media. Ooey gooey chocolatey good metadata.
They're uncompressed. 24 megs, that's good.
Why is that good?
More resolution, more metadata.
Metadata?
She doesn't know what metadata is.
This technology can either be used as a standalone searchable database, or it can be integrated into your NLE du jour or asset management system. Now, many of you may be familiar with PhraseFind, which was a scaled-down version of Dialogue Search available as a plugin to some versions of Avid Media Composer. But we're getting a little bit of ahead of ourselves here. Let's see where Dialogue Search is most beneficial. Nexidia's technology has many use cases, but as it pertains to post-production, it's fantastic for logging. Let's consider reality television. Many cameras, sometimes recording for most of the day. This is a massive amount of footage to comb through for that one scathing soundbite. Imagine being able to search across this and instantly find that soundbite you need, or the components you need to create that epic Frankenbite. It's a tremendous time saver.
Real with the occasional use of Frankenbiting.
Frankenbiting.
It's an editing technique. We take various pieces of audio and visual, we build the scene we want to build, kind of like Frankenstein building his monster.
Hi, my name is Werner Brandis. My voice is my passport. Verify.
In terms of metadata, Dialogue Search provides a way to find media in your archives without having to rely on the manual input of search terms. Many manual input terms in asset management cover broad topics or people, not phrases or quotes. Instead of searching by these concepts as most do, you now have a much more granular way of searching for content in only a few seconds, with little or no manual input of metadata needed. The next place that shows great promise is that of closed captioning. Closed captioning is a very expensive process, and due to the new FCC regulations, mandatory for many content providers. The technology behind Dialogue Search shows great promise for auto-generation of captioning. Unfortunately, at this point, it's not accurate enough for the strict guidelines required for captioning. However, it is accurate enough to be used in Nexidia's QC product, which can analyze an existing caption file, compare it to the media file, and retime the captioning to match the source media file. This drastically reduces the amount of your deliverables that could possibly be rejected, as well as, again, conforming to the FCC regulations.
FCC, you know what that means?
Yeah. Means Federal Communications Commission.
We at the FCC feel that democracy is all about protecting the rights of the ordinary citizen.
I know. Many of you are wondering about PhraseFind. Will it come back as an option for Media Composer? As a version 8 of Media Composer, PhraseFind is not available. There are licensing issues that Nexidia and Avid are still sorting out. No timetable has been set for definitive yes or no. And depending on who you talk to on both camps, discussions are either going well or horrible. Unfortunately, we're just going to have to wait and see. The current Oxford Dictionary lists over 170,000 words in the English language, not including obsolete and derivative words, regional terms, and slang. It would be wholly inefficient and quite impossible to maintain an accurate database of these words. So the fine PhD-level folks at Nexidia broke down the individual sounds that we make as we form words and use those discrete sounds as a blueprint for all speech, thus making it possible to search for any word or sound, even those which are not found in the dictionary.
Fubar.
Fubar. Fubar.
Look at Fubar in the German dictionary. There's no Fubar in there.
It turns out that all American English words are made up of one or more of 40 individual sounds, called phonemes, Combinations of several of these individual 40 sounds form every word we use. All of you Brits across the pond will be happy to know that you've got one more over us Yanks with 41 distinct phonemes. So you've got that and better tea.
And how was their tea?
It's not the same, really, is it?
As what?
Same as this good old-fashioned, proper, British, good, hot, fresh, good, fresh, good, warming, but not hotting, good, fresh, fresh, good tea, British.
Each language has their own individual phonemes. Nexidia has created indexes for several languages for dialogue search, with even more in development. Dialogue search, whether it's direct from Nexidia or part of the Phrase Find add-on component inside some versions of Media Composer, indexes media files and creates a database of all of the individual sounds. This allows the user to search for any word they can think of, and Nexidia will match up the word you're searching with the phonemes that make up the word. Since the media files are indexed as soon as they are added, the amount of time to search for a word happens in seconds. Dialogue Search will not only play the clips of the point in which the word shows up, but it can also export the results as an XML or AAF, so you can populate the results into your NLE. Nexidia also has advanced interoperability with CatTV as well as a panel for Adobe Premiere. Searching for a word isn't a yes or no proposition. A poor recording, background noise, or slurred speech can certainly skew results. That's why the Nexidia technology scores and rates the probability that the word you're looking for is actually being spoken. Nexidia also allows the user to define what constitutes an accurate score and which ones are bunk. Let's see a few examples. Here we are with Nexidia Dialogue Search version 1.5. And before we search, let's go over a few options to refine our search. Under Advanced Options, we have Search Sensitivity. This allows us to broaden or narrow the amount of search results based on how strict Dialogue Search is on matching words and phrases. We can also search by media date to further reduce the amount of potential results. Lastly, we can search various media pools. Pools are groups of media that the user organizes. This could be done by season, episode, or even talent. Let's search for our first word. Let's try alcohol. First off, you'll see that almost 13,000 hours were searched in under 1 second. This is because the search queried the index database, not each individual clip on every search. We have a result here from Rachel Maddow. I like the cut of her jib, so let's see how she talks about alcohol.
Caffeine and alcohol. The problem is not warning that really alcoholic and also really caffeinated whiskey as in alcohol, coffee as in caffeine, off before the alcohol does, and one of these high alcohol, high caffeine drinks.
As you can see in this case, scores from 83% to 94% are spot on. Let's try searching for a more obtuse word. How about twerk? You'll notice in the search bar the individual components that make up the word, the phonemes. Let's try result number 2. 91%, huh? I somehow doubt the word twerk is used.
When I first went to work for him in Texas, he was a popular bipartisan leader who had a record of working with Democrats.
Went to work. So, phonetically it matches, but it's not the exact word I was looking for. Let's try a phrase. How about hated it? We'll check out the first result.
Hated it. Now they're throwing it at least a little bit. I'll tell you, the bankers hated it. Now they're throwing it at least a little bit at some kind of love.
It got it. Let's up the ante yet again. This time we'll try the phrase, they hated it. Ah yes, Brian Williams. Let's see what he has to say.
And only vacated it 5 years ago. Did he have a blog he had? And only vacated it 5 years ago. Did he have a blog he had to write every?
Vacated it. So it's very close, but not perfect. Let's try the next result.
Every day that they hated the Constitution, that they were evil.
They hated the. Again, very close to getting the whole phrase, but not exactly. As you can see, in the right environment, it's fantastic. As the recording fidelity decreases, however, so does the accuracy. It's also heavily dependent on the speaker themselves.
You put the wrong emphasis on the wrong syllable.
Like many software technologies nowadays, Nexidia has both annual and perpetual licensing models, and all are based on tiered pricing options, consisting of how many active hours can be searched, as well as how many users, plus annual support. To reduce cost, many facilities reduce the amount of active hours that they have searchable. For example, you may only want to index the current season of your show, not every season. I know, for the average user, it's a bit expensive. But on the facility side, if we factor in the cost per hour of a logger or an editor over the course of a year, or the hundreds of dollars an hour for transcription services, or even the time spent combing through archives for footage, Dialogue Search becomes a cost-effective and efficient way to get your projects done quicker. Have any other tools you use to analyze audio? How about other tools to harvest quality metadata? Talk to me about it in the comments section. Also, please subscribe and share this nerd goodness with the rest of your nerdy friends. I plan to be back in 2 weeks with another 5 things. Until the next time, learn more, do more. Thanks for watching.